time, we'd like to go to the Lord in prayer. Fathers, we come unto you. Lord, we just ask, Lord, that you would take, Lord, and you would just continue, Lord, to be with this family. Lord, you've been with them, Lord, in these past few months during the sickness of Brother Andrew. And Lord, you've been with them, Lord, in these last few days in the passing of Brother Andrew. I pray that, Lord, you would just take, Lord, continue to lift them up, not just today, but tomorrow, and in the weeks to come, that, Lord, you would help them, Lord, to make it through. Lord, to each one of us that are here this morning, I pray that, Lord, you would be with us, Lord, and help us all, Lord, to remember the fond memories that we have of Brother Andrew Benson. Lord, we know that, Lord, in times such as these, we look unto thee for thy strength. Amen. Said, I thank God that I was able to see the sun come up this morning. Then he looked at me and he said, but you know, one of these days, he said, I'm going to see the one that tells the sun to come up. I thought about the scripture, and many of us have the scripture in our homes. Many of you can quote this very scripture that I'm going to read to you by heart. But the Bible simply says in Psalm 23, that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And I simply want to say to you that Andrew Benson is now meeting the shepherd. And so we went outside there and walked out there to that barn, and he opened up that barn door, and there sat that little John Deere tractor. He said, that you saw in the pictures is this right here. And I thought to myself, wow, that was amazing. He took something that looked like a pile of junk and made something beautiful out of it. And I thought about the scriptures. In Jeremiah chapter 18, the Bible says, the word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause thee to hear my word. He said, then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he wrought the work on the wheel, and the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hands of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I do with you as this potter saith the Lord? Behold, the clay is in the potter's hand. So are ye in my hand, O house of Israel. Now, as Brother Andrew took all of those pieces and he put them back together and made that beautiful tractor come back to life, you see, that is so much like the Bible here teaches. It talks about how that potter would take that clay, that simple clay. People can look at it and say, well, there's no use in it. But that potter would take and would put his hands upon it, and he would make a beautiful vessel. You know, you may be here this morning, and you may have made a mess in your life. You may be here and say, preacher, I have done some things in my life that I'm ashamed of. Well, you know what? We all have. We've all made mistakes. We all have sinned. But I'm glad to know that God can take us, and he can mold us into something beautiful for him. And when I think about Brother Andrew Benson, I think about a man that, my friends, he shared his faith with so many people. He would share his faith. He was a man that just was not a Christian on Sunday morning, but he was a Christian 24/7. He believed in the power of prayer. I mean, I've had him to look at me and tell me time after time how that he'd been through some rough times in his life with sickness, but he was always thanking God because he knew it was God that had helped him to make it through. And I thought about this morning. I thought about if I could talk with Brother Andrew. I believe Brother Andrew would say, preacher, tell them about Jesus Christ and how he can change their life, how he can make something out of them. The world may look at you, and the world may say, you know what, you've done this, and you've done that, and you've done all these things. The world may look at you and say, there's no good in you. But God says, wait a minute, I can do something with them. I can make something beautiful with them. So many times when somebody passes away, we'll make the statement that we have lost them. I want to say to you this morning, and I say this many times at the funeral, my friends, if you lose something, you don't know where it's at. If you lose your car keys, your wallet, or your cell phone, you don't know where it's at. I say unto you this morning, we have not lost Andrew Benson. We know where Andrew Benson is at. He's in the presence of the Lord. And let me tell you something this morning. Andrew Benson is not having a problem breathing this morning. Now, the Bible says that he's got a new body this morning. Can you imagine what heaven must be like when Mr. Andrew got there? I can just picture him right now when he got up to heaven. I can see him when he got there. The first thing I can see him doing is going, how y'all doing? Now, he was a southern gentleman. I can see right now how y'all do it. And I can imagine when he got there and he began to see family and friends and people that he had known. I could just imagine him seeing them. And then I can imagine him seeing the Lord. I thought about, you know, every Sunday morning when he was able to come, him and Miss Cynthia would sit over here on the right in the second pew. And he always would sit there, and I can remember seeing there. He had that smile on his face. Look, there were times that he came to church that he really didn't feel physically able to, but he came. Why? Because he loved the Lord. I say unto you, family, let me tell you for a fact this morning, this man loved you, family, and this man was so proud of you. There were times here in this church, there were times in his home, could go down there and we'd get to talking, and he would go to talking about something that you had done. And he would go to talking about just how proud he was of each and every one of you. And then Miss Cynthia, she would go and she would get some pictures out, and she would start showing some pictures. Or she would start telling. He would start telling about things that y'all had done and how he just loved you and how he was concerned about you. I remember, I believe it was a granddaughter that you have that was in the military. And I remember many times on Sunday mornings going out to church, he'd look at me and say, "Preacher, pray for her. She's over there. Lift her up in prayer." He prayed for you, and he was proud of you. And my friends, and he loved you. Let me tell you, if you were ever loved by anybody, if you could ever be loved by Andrew Benson, because he loved you and he cared about you. He had that smile about him. And you know, he could come up with some of the oldest things, and he would come up, and many times he'd ask you a question, and he could lift that eye up, and he would ask you that question. Lift that eye up and he asked that question, and you just sat there and he just watched you try to figure out the answer. And then when you finally couldn't figure out the answer, you'd be like, "I can't figure it out." He'd give you the most simplest answer to the question, and then he would smile about it. You see, he took and would take, and he'd take for many years. He laid bricks. Now, we go out there and we see a pile of bricks. And a lot of folks would say, "That ain't nothing but a pile of bricks there." But you see, Mr. Andrew would go out there and he could take those pile of bricks. He could make something beautiful out of them. You may ride by a home. You may even be living in a home today that Mr. Andrew laid the bricks at. He took that pile of bricks and made something beautiful out of them. And you know, that's just how God is. God can take us and use us. You know, God can use us in so many ways to touch the lives of many people. Over the period of time that I've been a pastor here, and I've gone and I've talked with different folks in the church, especially a lot of our older gentlemen in the church. And I would go and begin to talk with them, and many times they would bring up in the conversation about doing some things here around the church, and they would always bring up about Mr. Andrew. They'd always be like, you know, they say, "Andrew was sure was nice. Andrew did this, Andrew done that." You know what? They thought a lot of him. And I tell you what, we're going to miss him here at the church. This old preacher up here is going to miss him. But I tell you what, I know that he's in a better place. I think back to several years ago, one Sunday morning, we had communion and feet washing. And I remember I stood up here and we did the communion. And after the service was over with, I stood down there and I said, "At this time we're going to have feet washed and our ladies will remain in the sanctuary. And our gentlemen will adjourn back to the Sunday school room." And so all of us gentlemen went back there and we began to prepare for the feet washing. And as we're back there beginning to prepare to do the feet washing, I'll never forget this statement that he made. And since this time that he made that statement, I've used this at just about every funeral that I've ever preached. But he looked at all of us guys that were sitting there, and he said, "Gentlemen." Now when Mr. Andrew said, "Gentlemen," you know he's going to tell you something. He said, "Gentlemen, you may have put them shoes on this morning, but the undertaker can take them off tonight." And you know what? That's words of wisdom out there. That's the truth that has ever been told. You may have put your shoes on this morning, but you know what, my friends? The undertaker will be the one to take them off today. You see, none of us know in here which one of us will be the next one to go out. The next funeral that you attend could be your own. Several years ago, I stood in a church and I preached a funeral for a lady. She was 95 years old. When the service was over with, her grandsons and great-grandsons were her pallbearers. One of her grandsons was 18 years old. And I made the very statement that I just made to you, that one of us could be the next one to go out to eternity. Her funeral was on a Thursday afternoon. Had the funeral, had the graveside. That Saturday morning, the mother of that 18-year-old went in there to wake him up. Now, this 18-year-old young man, I want to tell you, if you look at him, he was in perfect health. He was in perfect condition. I mean, he had a scholarship to go to college to play baseball. I mean, he was just a great baseball player. But she went in there to wake him up, to get him to go to practice. And when she went in to wake him up, she couldn't get him up. He had died, 18-year-old, 95-year-old, and 18-year-old in the same family. You may be here and say, "Preacher, I've got plenty of time." Well, as Mr. Andrew Benson said, you may have put them shoes on this morning, but the undertaker can take them off tonight. You see, you need to look at your life and ask yourself, do you know the Lord is your personal Savior? You may be here and say, "Preacher, I've got a nice home. Preacher, I've got a big bank account. Preacher, I've got everything that I need. I don't care how big your house is. I don't care how much money you got in the bank. I don't care if you own a car dealership." My friend, none of those things matter whenever you draw that last breath. You see, when Mr. Andrew Benson was born, that day was appointed for him to leave this world. And in October of 2020, that time came. It came time for him to leave this world, and I know that, family, you're going to miss it. And I know that, family, you say, "Preacher, it just seems so hard." But you know what? You got to think about the good times. But that's what Mr. Andrew would do. He'd want you to think about the good times. And you're going to see things that are going to remind you of Mr. Andrew. I thought about it as I was in my study, and I was back there preparing for today, and I began to look for something. And all of a sudden there, in the little desk that I have, I ran across two pieces of wood. And I began to get emotional, and I began to think about how that one Sunday Mr. Andrew came up to me, and he handed me those two little pieces of wood. And they were shaped the way they were shaped. And he said, "Preacher, can you make this look like a square?" I believe it was. And I sat back there and I wrestled with that thing. And I've done everything. And I thought to myself, there's no way. There's no way. No way that can be done. I looked at him and I said, you can't do it. He lifted that eye and he had that little grin. He took and he put it right together. He said, "Look at here." And I thought to myself, I said, "Man, that was cool." And you know, I was sort of a little bit like Mr. Andrew. I went to work the next day, and this fellow come in there, and he's a whole lot smaller than I am. And I looked at him, and I said, "Hey, can you put this together and make it a square like out of it?" And I mean, he sat there, and he wrestled with that thing. He said, "It can't be done." And well, I couldn't remember like Mr. Andrew did, so I took put him with a mark over there. And I put them things together and showed him. He said, "How did you come up with that?" I said, "I didn't." He said, "Man," he said, "whoever come up with that, he had to been an engineer." And he went to tell me, I said, "No, this gentleman wanted to engineer." I said, "This gentleman here's got more sense than me and you both got put together. He can figure out things." One of the things that Brother Andrew did, he worked at the prison up there. And you know, I thought about many times when somebody goes to prison, many times we sort of say there's no hope for them. We sort of just cast them to the side there. But I've heard him say, and I've heard Miss Cynthia say, they could go places and somebody would holler, Hey, Mr. B. You see the impact that he has had on life. He took something of that tractor that would have been nothing, and a lot of people would say, where a lot of people would have gave up on his inmates, he showed them something. You see, we never know the impact that we could have on the lives of people. So I say unto you today, know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Have him in your life. that when you draw your last breath, you know, whenever you take your last breath and you leave this world, one of the greatest assurances that you can give your family is your family to know that you've gone to heaven. As a minister, I've had people come up to me, look at me and say, "Preacher, I just don't know. I just don't know if Mama or Daddy made it into heaven." My friends, and that bothered them more than anything else. But we can say this morning that we know by the life that he lived, Brother Andrew's at, where he's gone to, that beautiful place called heaven. I'd like to say to you this morning, on behalf of this family, they'd like to thank everybody for everything that you have done for them during the sickness of Brother Andrew, the phone call, the visits, the prayer, and the food, and the passing of Mr. Andrew. They just also want to thank you for everything that you have done for them, for the phone calls and the prayers and the food that you have sent. And one of the things I always say at a funeral is simply is this. Many times we call and we'll visit and we'll pray for a family, but then after the funeral service is over with, after the graveside service is over with, and we all begin to get back to our lives, it is then that this family is still going to need your prayers and your concerns. So pick up the phone next week and give them a call and let them know that you're thinking about them, that you got them in our prayers. I say to the family, and I shared this with them, I thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to be able to speak at Brother Andrew Benson's funeral. But as I had said to y'all, I believe that every man, woman, boy, and girl, when they walk upon the face of this earth, preach their own funeral. And I would have to say that Mr. Andrew Benson has done a good job. He preached his own funeral with the life that he lived. A man that loved the Lord, loved his family, and loved his wife. And I tell you what, we got y'all in our prayer, and we're praying for y'all. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father, I come this morning, Lord, my heart's heavy. For Lord, this man that I've known, as a fellow Christian and as a great friend, the Lord, it's just been a blessing to know him. And Lord, in these past few months, to see him in the condition that he was in, when he was able, when he came to the church, when go into his home and visit with him. And Lord, he was always thanking you. He was always saying just how good that you had been to him. And Lord, I thank you for what you have blessed him with. I thank you, Lord, for his family. For Lord, you blessed him with one of the greatest gifts that any person could have, and that would be a loving family. And Lord, I thank you for them. I thank you, Lord, for the love that they have for one another. And Lord, I lift this family up in prayer. Lord, I lift our church up in prayer. For Lord, there is an empty spot in our hearts this morning. For Lord, we're going to miss him. But we know that he is now rejoicing. He's in that place called heaven. And we know that, Lord, if Brother Andrew could speak to us, if he could talk to us right now, he would tell us need to know you as personal Savior. That how, Lord, he could take something that was nothing, he could make something so beautiful of it. How the Lord, you could do the same thing with us. Lord, we can't change what we did yesterday. But Lord, I know that, Lord, you can take, and Lord, you can help us with the future. And Lord, I lift the family up, the church family, I lift everyone that is here this morning up in prayer. That, Lord, you will be with us. And, Lord, you would just give us that strength that we need to have to go from day to day. Thank you for him. Thank you for his family. Thank you, Lord, for the testimony. Lord, he shared with those that he met in Tennessee. Lord, just be with us and bless us in all things. Amen. Amen. Please stand at this time.
There's a brand new start up in heaven.